is Scott, and I'm here to do another video for you today. And if you're just now seeing me, welcome to my channel, YouTube channel, Skate Bar by Scott. And again, subscribe and hit that old like button and share that video for me. I would appreciate it. If you're just now seeing me, I hope you come back and see me as well. All right. Today is the 27th of February, 2024, and this will be my 117th video. So, with all that said, let's get to painting. Yes, indeed. All right. As you can see, this is an old black canvas here, 16 by 20. And today I'm going to attempt to paint, again, I will say attempt to paint a sunset desert scene for you today. Bear with me on this one. All right. Got my old mist bottle up here, and I'm just going to mist this right here. If you think you got too much water up here, just come up here with your clean brush and just brush it, and it'll leave it nice and slick. So, and I'm going to come right here and give me some alizarin crimson on my brush in here. Decide already, you need to decide where you're going to, your horizon line is going to be. And I think I'm going to put my right in here. Something like this here. Alright. Now, without even cleaning my brush, I'm going to go right into some yellow. And I'm going to pick me on a spot, let's say right here, and just work it out. Do not go back in that center again, because it will just, it will dirty up that center, okay? So, be careful of that. Now, I put that red on here, that crimson, because you want yellow on black, you're going to turn green. There's a little green up here, but I'm about to fix that. So, yeah, be careful with that, okay? And now, I'm going to clean this off over here. And I'm going to go right back in that yellow a little. Right back into it. Come right up in here. Hit it. And just let it fade right on out. And something like that. And I'm going to come in here and get a little bit of yellow ochre right here. And maybe come right up in here somewhere. A little golden color. Something like that. Yeah. Give me a little bit of white. Pick out your highlight. My highlight is going to be right here. So come back in here. Give you some white paint right here. Let's just work that in a little bit here. Do not go back in that center, because that's going to be the highlight of it, the brightest spot. You went back in there with that dirty brush, you know, it's going to get all dull on you. So again, just always, you know, wipe it off, clean it off, whatever. Go right in here again, bam, and work it out. Just like that. Mm-hmm. If you think you got too much white paint, you can take your knife and just scrape it. Scrape off that excess. I'm about to blend it out here. All right. Again, right here in the center. Now let's just start blending this. Come right back in here with some more white paint. this little spot right here. Need it a little bit brighter. So, come right back. Get a little dry on me, a little mist. Take care of that. No problem. There, nice and slick. You know, without that mist, it's kind of like trying to blend cement. Kind of, it just real gets real dry, real thick, you know. Let's see here. Now, I don't have enough work. I'm going to have to hit the camera off. Be right back. I miss more Elizabeth Crimson. I just want a little crimson right up in here. Somewhere up there like that. Then I'm going to come down here just to get just a smidgen. That means a small amount of some Prussian blue. And come right up in here. And of course, we all know that blue and crimson makes a nice little purple color. And you can come right down in here. See the little purplish color? You can get away with that, bringing it down to here and all this yellow color. Because, you know, purple and yellow is all right together. It is all right. Color. You know, the little few little clouds is what I'm putting in here. Just a few little clouds. A little color up in here. There. Maybe even smooth that out a little. Make me some little distant mountains back here. And then the way I understand, mountains in the desert, they got these little bluffs or whatever you want to call them. Something like this. Where the, you know, the tops of them are just flat and they come down. And but anyway, that's what I'm going to attempt to do here. One mountain, and this is a mixture of some white, blue, and black. A little gray color here. Let's come right up in here. Let's do another one. Something like this. Again, if you are just watching me for the first time, you know the way that I paint. It just basically, this is my thoughts on canvas. I ain't looking at nothing. There's nothing off to the side where I'm copying. You know, I don't trace. You know, I don't have no plan other than what's in my mind. There's no sketching or nothing. So I kind of just let it go. Now, I want to make some more mountains, but a little closer, a little darker. So I just add a little bit more of that blue and black mixture. And I'm going to come right up in here. Put me in another one. But as we know, these stuff get, they get a little darker as they get forward, right? A little more detail. There's just very distant little mountains back here. And when I get down here, you know, I'll start working on some detail. There. color. There. Need to make that a little bit darker. Because I want this one to be separated from that one. Start working on my little, before I get too far ahead, I haven't put me some sand start through here. So I gotta cut the camera off and I gotta mix me up a little bit of paint for the sand and all, and I'll be right back. There. I hope I got the color right. I don't really know what desert sand color is. So I'm just gonna wing it here and come right up in here. Some old sand color right through here. This is some just brown and white that I mixed. So just bear with me, that ain't the color of sand. I don't know. But it is in this painting. And just let it come right around. Kind of leave some in this dark color showing also. Sun here, a little sunset, and I want to start going a little darker color, get further away. A little bit, maybe there's a little sand dune right here, and just pop it in. There's a little dune there. Yeah. Maybe there's another one. Cover all this in, alright, so I'm going to hit the camera off, alright, and then I'll be right back. Alright, below these little sand dunes, if you want to just pop in a little color right through here, something like that. Make it stand up. Sun is going right down in the sand here. There. Now, before I get too far into this painting, let's come back up in here and let's start putting in some the little cactus plants way back here. Cacti. big. No, don't do that. I'll make bigger ones when I get down here in the foreground, so I'll make a little better ones for it. Alright, double load my brush. I'm going to put me one more nice big mountain right through here somewhere. Right here. Down, maybe it comes up here, something like this. Come down with a little bit. Yeah, there you go. And that gives me a little area right back in here. Yep. A little bit further than that. There it is. Sun, all that light coming in. So let's say this light got some yellow ochre. Let's just highlight some of that. Where that sun might be hitting. Not too much. Now I'm gonna come up here just a little bit of this brown color I got. Notice I'm using the brush, right? I'm not using my palette knife. You know, want to brush this on, you know, desert. You know, all that wind and all it kind of smooths out these rocks. So, and that's what I'm doing here. Just put a little color. These right here, probably gonna leave alone. They're a little bit too far away to see all this. A little too far away. I might hit a little bit right there. Maybe. Let's try it. Just a little bit. Step back, see what I got, be right back. Alright, now let's start putting in a little bit more cactus right here. A little cactus right there. I'm using a little bigger brush now. The one that I put on here was with the lighter brush. And this is just an old flat brush right here. Making your cactus plants or plant whatever trees, it's better that I show you. Okay, I'll come back to that point here in a minute. Just like that. Coming right along. I wanted to make. Okay. When you're doing your arms on your cactus plants, kind of have it curving in, because if you come right here and you go straight over, you look like you're making field goal posts, you know, on a football field. You don't want that. No. So have it come down just a little curl. That's it. And let's come over here. I mean, is it even looking like a desert scene? This one here kind of popped in my mind. Kind of wanted to do one. Desert scenes, you know, they're kind of not my thing. Just like, you know, seascapes, you know, I still have difficulties with that. I don't even know how many arms are supposed to be on a cactus. I hope that's all right. Let's have a big one right here. White paint on a brush here. I'm going to put in a little bit of yellow ochre. And I just want to highlight some of these right here. There. Right here, my son. Too good on that one. Let me get my old liner brush. There it is. How about this here? Yeah, that's a little better there now. Arm. on the tree. It don't matter what tree you're painting. Always have that land coming up somehow or another. Right. Back here too. All the way back in here. Bottom of your cactus, I like to put them in some little things right through here. You know, little desert plants or whatever. Almost done with this painting already. Almost. Hey guys, I believe I'm going to call this one done. I hope you enjoyed it. A little desert scene, sunset desert scene I did for you. Give it a try. And I hope you come back and see me. Again, I'm Scott. And welcome to my channel here, Escape Art by Scott. And like always, subscribe to that channel for me, guys. Really need some help with that one. And hit that old like button. That'll keep my videos going. Okay, if you guys really like them, you know, subscribe to the channel for me. And until next time, I hope you come back and see me. And until then, you guys take care. Bye-bye.